Hey guys, welcome to Laratips. In today's video, we'll be looking at four new things that are added to Laravel version 8.72.0. The first thing that is added is support for countables to the pluralizer. Before, in order to get the plural form of these users, we had to do it like this. So let's say, for example, here is a user word and we want to get the plural of this user. Before, if we wanted to get the plural form of the user according to the count, then we had to do it like this. If here we have one, then it will return user, and if here is more than one, then it will return users. So currently I am getting users from the database and I am just passing its count. So currently I am only taking one user. So if I just reload here, we can see user over here. Now if I get two, then I'll see here users. But what's new here is we don't have to pass this count now. It will automatically know that it is a countable, so it will get the count by itself. So I'll just reload over here. You can see I'm getting users. Now if I just change it to one and again reload, then I'm getting here user. So instead of this, you can also pass array, let's say one. You can see here you are getting one, and if I pass here another one, there are two items in this array, so it will return users. Okay, this is one feature that is added. Now the next thing that is added is declined validation rule. So let me just uncomment it. Now here I have just passed the data myself, but you can just pass the data from the request. So I am just passing here involved in crime as true. So if it is true, then it will decline. So let me just refresh it. So you can see here the validation message shows the involved in crime must be declined. So if you want to decline anything, then you can just add this validation rule. Now let us look at the third feature that is added. A method to the macroable trait that removes all the configured methods has been added. So here is the test written in the pull request. I'll be leaving all these links just below that like button. So you can see here a new flushed method macro is created for this test macroable class. And here it is testing that this flushed method is same as that instance flushed method, because whenever we create this new test macroable and call this flushed method, then it is returning this flushed method, so it must be same. So it is returning true. But if we just run this test macroable and flush macros, then all the macros that has been defined will be removed. And if we try to call this flushed method on this instance, then bad method call exception will be called. So here it is expecting the exception and calling this flush method, then bad method call exception will be thrown. So this new flush macros has been added to this Laravel version 8.72.0. Now the last and fourth thing that has been added is the new extra method reset URL on the reset password. Let's say you want to send user a different URL whenever they try to reset the password instead of the default one. Now you can easily do that by just overriding this reset URL method on the reset password.php, which I'll show you here. So I am here in this user model. So you can see here can reset password. Inside here you will see send password reset notification. You can just copy it and paste it here on the user model, not in here but inside the user model here. You can see here this is extending this authenticable, which is this user which I have shown you before. Okay, so you can just override it or paste it over here, this send password reset notification, and you can create a new notification which extends this reset password notification. Okay, so this reset password notification is actually this reset password. Okay, so here you can see here reset URL like this. So you can just override this reset URL method where you will get this notifiable, which is the user itself. And whatever you return from here, that URL will be sent to the user's email.